Hello and welcome to QnA Friday. I'm Raghav and you are watching the channel Automation Step by Step. And today I'm going to take up a question asked by Charan. And Charan says, I heard software testing is going to disappear in IT. Can you please clarify my doubt? Charan, thank you so much for asking this question. And before I go a little deeper and give you some more insights, let me give you a very straight and short answer to this, and that is, software testing is not going to disappear, it's here to stay. Of course, there are going to be some changes in the ways of testing, in the modes of testing, or I should say the preferences for the ways of testing, but definitely software testing is not going out, it's here to stay. Now, having said that, let us go a little more deeper into your question. And of course, there are going to be some changes at the industrial level. And there are three things that I want to discuss with you. The first thing is, there's going to be shift to faster and quicker ways of testing. And you must have guessed that the faster and quicker way of testing is automation testing. Of course, there are some testing which has to be done manually, but the shift is towards doing more and more automation testing. Now, here you do not have to worry. Even if you are a manual tester, you can start with any basic automation testing tool and start learning it. I know a lot of people who are into manual testing have given me this question that automation is going to be difficult, it's going to be complex, how we are going to, you know, manage it. The thing is, it's not difficult and it's not complex. If you start with some very basic tool, it's going to be very interesting. And you know, I have a lot of beginner tutorials on my channel. You can watch that, or you can watch any other online resources, and you will come to know that it's not as difficult or complex as you might have thought it to be. So this is one thing that you have to do in case you want to remain in this industry. If you can learn some basic automation, that will be very helpful. The second thing is, there is going to be shift to shorter releases cycle, and there is going to be a focus on DevOps. So again, for DevOps and for continuous integrations, if you can learn some basic tools like Jenkins, that will be very, very helpful. And again, learning Jenkins is again not a very, you know, complicated thing. There's not a lot of programming involved in that. As you know, most of the people fear that there will be a lot of programming, so I cannot do it. It's not like that. You can watch my series on Jenkins, or you will get a lot of online information. So having a knowledge of one of the CI tools will help you a lot. And the third thing is, in the industry, there is going to be increase in demand for people who can provide end-to-end automated testing solutions. So of course, if you have knowledge of automation as well as some CI tools in DevOps, then you can fit into this picture. But even if you do not worry. If you can get some basic knowledge for automation, some basic tools, and some basic tool for CI, that should suffice. So the thing here is, the testing trends or the focus on testing is going to shift towards more of automated testing. And even if you are a manual tester, do not worry, you can very easily learn some tools, some concepts of automation testing, and you should be fine. And software testing in IT is going to stay for now. So that was all for this session. In case you have any other questions, you can write me at ask.qnafriday@gmail.com. Please mention your name and location. I will meet you in the next session of QnA Friday. Thank you for watching.